So last lecture, and we introduce, so what we did in the second part was homotopy, fundamental group, coverings, then we computed fundamental groups of the circle, of the two-sphere, of real projective spaces. These were the main examples, okay, more or less. Here's the last important concept from algebraic topology, which are homotopy equivalents. That's also a very basic notion. So what is the definition? So let F from x to y be continuous, always continuous, of course. F is a homotopy equivalence if there exists a continuous map. If there is a continuous map in the other direction, G from y to x, such that we have first f and then g this is homotopic, okay? Homotopy, sign for homotopy, to the identity of x. And first G and then F is homotopic to the identity of Y. So these are the conditions for homotopy equivalence. If we example is a homeomorphism, of course, okay? Example, a homeomorphism. That's, well, F. That's an example. Then we have equal here, right? Then we have equal, but now we have weaker, and we write not equal, but homotopic only, okay? So we will understand, try to understand a little bit of this notion. That's a very basic notion of algebraic topology, homotopy equivalence, one of the most important. Okay. So then one says that if there exists, one say, if, that's a way to talk, if there is a homotopy equivalence. So X and Y are homotopy equivalent. So spaces, X and Y are homotopy equivalent. And sometimes one just says homotopic, maybe. But this is homotopic spaces, okay? Not maps now, okay? They are homotopy equivalency spaces, or they're just homotopic as spaces. So we have, if there exists a homotopy equivalence, okay? If there exists, there is a homotopy equivalence. F from X to Y. Then they are called equivalent with respect to homotopy, homotopy equivalent, or just homotopic, okay? This is, by the way, an equivalence relation. This homotopy equivalence, this is an equivalence relation. For topological spaces in general, very general. For topological spaces. Well, I will not prove this now, okay? So this you can say, if you want, as an exercise. Because I don't want to examples, so we have to get a feeling for this. We have to do examples, right? Examples. To have a feeling, what does it mean? Also homeomorphism is an equivalence relation, right? But if two spaces are homeomorphic, they are equal in some sense, okay? Here they are not equal, it's weaker, much weaker, so the classes are much longer. So definition, then here's another definition then, starting examples. A topological space is contractible. X is contractible. If the identity map of X is homotopic to a constant map, So this means identity X is homotopic to constant maps in some point, X0 and X. That's contractible, okay? So what has it to do with homotopy equivalences? So there is a little remark. Another exercise, if you want. I will do that. But it's very easy. So if X is contractible, if and only if. X is contractible if and only if. X is homotopy equivalent to a one-point space. Okay, these are the one-point spaces. X is homotopy equivalent to a one-point space. So here also we write, X and Y are homotopy equivalent if there's a homotopy equivalent. And one writes also here, which is convenient, X is homotopic to Y. Okay? This means homotopic. So somebody writes for homeomorphism, okay? In general, for isomorphism, homeomorphism, we write X, this, for homeomorphism, okay? This is homeomorphism. But this is just a notation, of course, okay? This is homeomorphism, this is homotopy equivalent, okay? This is isomorphism in algebra, isomorphism. We write very often in this way. Somebody writes this way, but in topology it's not good because this is homotopy, okay? Well, so this means to one point space, this means X is homotopic to just one point, X0, wherever that is, in X or not in X, doesn't matter. Just a name. So exercise. Well, let's do then this exercise to get used to this. This is very trivial because there are no maps to one-point spaces, okay? Almost no maps, okay? So just to get used to the definition, so proof of this. So we have two directions. X is contractible. So let's suppose X is contractible. X is homotopic to one point, but there are no maps, okay? So so this means we have that the identity map is, X is homotopic to a constant map, X0 in X. That's the definition, no? That is the definition of where is it? This one, okay? This is a definition. For some X0 in X, no? Maybe it's not so clear if it depends on X0, which one, okay? Okay, so that we have now, okay? And now we have to define mappings, F, from X to X0. But we have no choice here, no? This is a constant mapping, of course, okay? Constant. No choice at all. And then G, from the in the other direction, X0 in X. And X0 is a point of X already, okay? So I take an inclusion just here. That's the only reason. choice, and then what we have, of course, is if you take first G and then F, then it's equal to the identity. If first G and then F, then it's equal to the identity. It's equal to the identity of this, okay? And if you take first F and then G, so what is this mapping? So first F, everything goes to X0, and then we are in X0, and we go back to X, inclusion. So that's the constant map, X0, okay? So this is the constant map, X0. Constant map in X0, okay? From X to X. And this is homotopic to the identity by definition, homotopic to the identity of X now. So we have these two conditions again, you know? So this means that F and G are homotopy equivalents, okay? F is homotopy equivalence, and G is the inverse. It's also homotopy equivalence. It's symmetric, okay? There's one direction, easy, and the other one is as easy, equally easy. So this direction now we have to prove. So F is homotopy equivalent to one-point space. So what does it mean? We have a mapping from F to a one-point space. Now it's Y0. I don't know which point it would be. So I give another name. And then we have a mapping G from Y0. That's a point here. To X such that first F and then G, what is this? Y0 goes to X. So this is even equal. No, sorry. First F, then. Which mapping is this? That's first X goes to a point, then the point goes back to X. So this is a constant map. In which point? In G of Y0. Everything goes to G of Y0, okay? And of course, this, by definition, is homotopic to the identity, okay? So this is homotopic because this is a homotopic, these are homotopic equivalences, so this is homotopic to the identity of X. So this, okay? So that's all. Okay, so this is an easy exercise. The contractible spaces are exactly the spaces which are homotopy equivalent to one-point spaces. So these are the trivial spaces in the sense of homotopy, okay? Example, standard example, of course, is Rn is contractible. So seen from the view of point of homotopy, okay, Rn is trivial, okay, from homotopy. It's just as a point, nothing else from no. This is our usual straight line homotopy, okay. So we have to find a mapping, contractible. So what we have to prove? We have to prove that the identity of Rn is homotopic to what? To a constant map, okay? To some constant map. So constant, well, let's take zero in Rn, okay? Constant map. So we have to define such a homotopy, H. And so H of XT. One minus T times X. Or T times X, but it's symmetric, okay. Let's try this, one minus T times X. So at time T equals zero, this is the identity mapping, okay? At time t equals 0, this is just X. So this is the identity mapping. And at time one, we have zero, everything goes to zero, so this is this mapping, okay? So this is just this homotopy. Again, straight line, okay? Straight line homotopy. We go from each point x to back to zero, okay? So this is a straight line homotopy. Going from x to 0 on the straight line during the time interval from 0 to 1, okay? So Rn is contractible. But another example, many small examples, almost trivial examples. So for example, x is always homotopic to x cross I. If I take a product with an interval, the homotopy type doesn't change. The reason is that this is contractible. Okay. So again, it's a trivial proof almost. So we have to find f. Well, now I write r instead of f. So x cross I to x in one direction. Okay, I need a map, and I take the most natural map, x times t. Is equal to x. Okay? That's, let me call it f, sorry. And g in the other direction. From x to x cross I. So x goes to, any point goes to, g of x equal to well, we can choose x0. Doesn't matter, yeah, right. We can x times 0, okay, for example. And then, of course, we already have one thing, which is that what do we have? First f, first g, and then f, first g, and then f. This is equal, in this case, to the identity of first f. First g, so identity of x. This is equal to the identity of x, OK? And then we have to take f and then g the other direction. So x cross I projects to x, and then everything xt goes to x0. That's the mapping now, okay? So x times t goes to x times 0, okay? That's this mapping, yeah, okay, the composition. So we have to prove that this is homotopic to the identity of x times the interval, right? It's not equal, obviously, now, because xt is, it's like a projection. And so we have to define homotopy again, homotopy of so I wrote t now, okay? I have two parameters in the interval, because it's x cross I already. Times another I for the homotopy, okay? So I should have called this S, probably, and then use T for the homotopy. Sorry about that. So it doesn't, it's not big difference, okay? Just write S here. And then we have S, X cross S goes to X cross 0, right? And now I have X. It's x cross I, okay? That's a point here, and then t, the time parameter, okay? Times t is equal to x, so we won't leave x, times, so try s times t, something like that, or minus 1, okay, s times t. Both in the interval, right? So at t equals 0, this, at t equals 0, this is 0, so this is this mapping. Okay? At t equals 1, it's the identity of x cross I. X cross s goes to x cross s. Okay? So it's a homotopy between these two. Okay. So exercise. If y is contractible, then x is homotopic to x cross y. If I multiply with the contractible space, it doesn't change the homotopy type. Okay. This is like a point. From, okay, so that's very reasonable. Okay. So this I will not do. If y is contractible, then x. Okay. That's. What else? Another example. So I'm doing only examples. Example. So Rn minus 0, we know already that is homeomorphic to what? Sn minus 1 times. Real, I write bigger than zero, real, positive reals. So this is contractible, okay? So we do the same proof here, only we have to, this is positive reals now, but this proof works. We cannot take zero, but we have to take one or some point in the positive reals. Doesn't matter too much, okay? However, so this is homotopic, would be homotopic to Sn minus 1. But I can give a direct proof without using this. So let's this is also the very trivial. So but let's do it. So we define a map. These are the standard maps. X run minus zero goes to f goes to Sn minus one. So what mapping do we have? Of course, we have x goes to x over x, that's in one direction. And the other one is g, which goes from Sn minus 1 to Rn minus 0. And what to take? Well, this is a subspace anyway, so we take just the inclusion, okay? So this is the inclusion. So now I write different letters, okay? R, this is a retraction. So this is a retraction. That means so R, and this is the inclusion. So that means first the inclusion, then the retraction. This is equal to the identity, no? Of Sn minus 1. So this implies R is a retraction. Okay? And the other one we have to prove. So first R, and then I. So this should is not equal to the identity, but should be homotopic to the identity of Rn minus 0. This is the other space. Okay, so we have to define homotopy here, and we again have straight line homotopy. It's always the same because we are in Rn, okay? So these are the two conditions. One time we have equal even, okay? That's a retraction. And the other time we have homotopic, okay? This has also a special name, which I... Right, first let me define the homotopy. So the homotopy H of which is our space? Rn minus 0, x, t is equal to. So this should go from the identity. So from the identity t equals 0, 1 minus t x What is this mapping? R, first R, the retraction, and then the inclusion. That goes to Sn minus 1, everything, okay? With the retraction, it goes to S minus 1, and then it remains Sn minus 1. So this is, the other point is x over x. That's t plus t. So this is again straight line homotopy, always the same. So we have to be sure that this is different from zero, however, okay? Straight line homotopy. Again, straight line, because we have Rn, only in Rn. So the picture is this, of course. I mean, I can make a picture in R2 or R3, no? So if a point x here, then what we do, we have here the point x over x norm, right? And then we just let the point walk on this, avoiding zero, okay? We go from x to on this segment between 0 and 1 for each point. In the inside, we go the other direction, okay? If you have a point here, x, then this is x over x, and we walk in this direction. So this is another definition. All this is maybe the most important class of homotopy equations are these, okay? So a definition, still a definition, many definitions. A retraction R from X to a subspace A. So what does it mean? That means that first the inclusion and then the retraction is the identity of A. That means a retraction, okay? That's the definition of retraction. It retracts onto the subspace without changing the subspace, identity on the subspace, okay? That's a retraction. And a retraction is a deformation retraction. So this is an important definition also. It's a deformation retraction if we have in the other direction, first the retraction, then the inclusion, is homotopic to the identity of X now of the large space. Okay? So here's one condition, equal again, and here's the other one, only homotopic. Okay? That's a deformation retraction. This is an example of a deformation retraction, right? This is a retraction, and this, that's an example. So a deformation retraction is homotopic, okay? That's the most important example, deformation retractions, okay? So this implies a deformation retraction. It's a homotopy equivalence. Of course, not all examples of this type, because this requires A to be a subspace of X, right? If you don't have spaces which are not subspaces, one of the other, then we don't have this notion of deformation retractions, only of homotopy equivalence in general, right? So this is the most example, important. However, this is still the most, this is easy to see in general, okay? So somebody example, another example of a deformation retraction. Somebody of you mentioned the Möbius band, okay, last time as a surface. So intuitive example, okay? So the Möbius band, how is it defined? I mean, there are many Möbius bands, okay? So what you do is you take a band, and then you close. If you close in this, you take a band, okay? A band is just an interval times I, okay? You take a band, and then you close in this way. What you get is a cylinder, right? And now you close not in this way, but you close in this way, and then you get the Möbius band. So to make a picture, we have one twist here. Well, everybody knows, because it's a famous, maybe the most famous symbol of mathematics, okay, is the Möbius band, which you see Well, there's one other, which is a trefoil knot, okay? The other one. The trefoil. That's a Möbius band, okay? The trefoil is this one. So under, over. This is a trefoil, okay? This is the other. These are the two most famous symbols of mathematics, which you see everywhere, okay? Anyway, this, we are not interested in this one. So I say, so this is Möbius band M. Okay. Of course, there are many Möbius bands, so large, small, but they're all homeomorphic. Okay. This is a subspace of R3, of course. Okay, subspace. That's as a subspace of R3. That's a topology. Okay, we are in R3. Like the torus, right? That's a subspace of R3 also, or of R4. Okay, you can. That we said last time, okay? A torus S1 torus S1, which lives in R4, but the picture we make in R3, okay? From point of view of topology, these tori are the same, homeomorphic. From point of view of differential geometry, they're very different. That you will see. So now I want to say this is homotopic to S1. This is just homotopic to the circle. So from point of view of homotopy theory, it's a circle. Well, it looks like a circle. No? What you have are rotation numbers again, right? If you take a base point, and then you go here, well, you can go in this direction, but that doesn't matter so much. So you could just count how many times you go around, okay? And the fundamental group should be the integers again, no? Given by, okay? That's the case. Which S1 do we take? That's the only interesting thing. Which S1? There's a boundary which does not work well, okay? The boundary is not okay here, so we have to take the middle line. The central line. So this is our S1. It's a circle, right? The central line. The boundary line here goes two times around. This goes one time around, okay? You don't want to go two times around, just one. So we take the central line. And now we define our retraction in the most obvious way. We just project everything onto the central line along the intervals, okay? We have these intervals all. So you take a segment times interval, okay? So you have all these intervals, and then you close. So still, you have all these intervals, okay? Vibration by intervals, right? So we so if you have a point x here, then this point is r of x. We just project along this straight line. And here the same in the other direction, okay? So this defines the map R from the Möbius band to S1, which we have considered a subspace of M in this way, okay? And this is a retraction. It's a retraction. This is a retraction. But it is a deformation retraction. So we have the inclusion and we have the retraction. So this is this map what you see. Everything gets, okay, you go down to S1, okay? You, how do you say in English? You squash or whatever, I don't know, the Möbius band and to the center line, okay? That's a very intuitive map, of course, right? And now we want to prove that this, in fact, is homotopic to the identity map of the Möbius band, okay? So I will not write a formula now because I make it by picture. So at time zero, we have the identity map. At time one, everything is in this point, right? And it's clear what we do at time 1/2. What do? We just take 1/2 here, okay? So we let this interval get smaller and smaller. At the end, it's a point. That's our homotopy. Again, some kind of straight line homotopy if we consider this an interval, right? So this is a homotopy. At time one, we have the identity, okay, of this interval. At time zero, we just have a point. And now we let this between 0 and 1 go down to a point in a linear way. Okay? It's an interval. So this implies that this R is a deformation retraction. That's an example of a deformation. So the Möbius band is just from seen from point of homotopy, it's S1. Okay? Okay. So that means that M is homotopic to S1. Of course, S1, it's a cylinder. We can do the same, no? It's a cylinder. It's S1 cross I. That's when we close without a twist, okay? That's a cylinder. And this is, we proved even, X cross I is always homotopic equivalent to X, okay? And this is an equivalence relation. So this implies then, of course, that the Möbius band is homotopic to the cylinder. Okay. Seen from point of view of somebody, they don't differ, okay? This is not a, a retraction, because these are different spaces now, okay? But the easy space is this one, okay, in this class, and not this one, and not this one, okay? The easiest representative is S1. You will not find something easier in this equivalence class, okay, of S1. But you have the Möbius band, you have the cylinder, you have many things. Okay? So this is a homotopy equivalence. Just an example of homotopy equivalence, which is not a retraction, which is not a deformation retraction, right? Because these are different spaces. Now. Okay, and now, as I said already, so fundamental group. We go to fundamental group now. The Möbius band, what you suspect anyway, is a fundamental group should be the integers, okay? And you again have something like rotation. You count how many times you go around, okay? It's like S1, okay? So the question is, if we have homotopic spaces, what happens with fundamental groups? They should be isomorphic, okay? That's the idea. Z here, Z also here, okay? So that we will prove now. Well, yeah. Okay, so we have to prove something, and now I prove this. This is an important definition, okay? Homotopy equivalence, homotopic spaces, retraction, deformation retraction, okay? Contractible space. These are very basic definitions of algebraic topology. This is more algebraic than general topology, okay? So, proposition. The problem is that homotopy between maps, okay, does not preserve base points in general, okay? So we have problem with fundamental group. So it moves the base, homotopy can move the base point of the fundamental group, okay? So we have to compare fundamental groups with different base points. So let H be a homotopy. X cross I to Y be a homotopy. Homotopy between so we call FT of X, we may call FT of X equal to H of XT, no, at time T, for a fixed time T, okay? For a fixed T. In the interval. So what is H? It's homotopy between F0 at time zero and F1. So this is a homotopy between these two maps, okay? And now let alpha, it's a little bit technical, this one, but it's important. Let alpha from I to x be the path. So we fix the point anyway. So what is it called? X0. So let fix x0 in x. That's the base point, okay? But this, during the homotopy, is moved in general, okay? It's not fixed. So let alpha from I to x be the path which x0 moves during the homotopy, okay? So this path, how does it move? So be the path alpha of t equal of ft of x0. So we have fixed our point and look. So this is just h of x0t. X0 is fixed. No, that's a path. It's a continuous mapping because h is continuous, okay? It's a restriction to one point here. Then so this is now the conclusion. Then, so we want to compare F0 star and F1 star, the induced maps on fundamental group. Okay, I will make a diagram, then it's clearer. So they are not equal because F0 of the base point is in general different from F1 of the base point. They cannot be equal, okay, these maps, because they go to different base points, okay? However, we have this mapping alpha hat. So now I make alpha hat is the isomorphism from one base point to the other base point of fundamental group. If we have a path, we define this. And this is exactly this. So I make a diagram which makes it more clear. Anyway, this is a point, but the diagram is this one. So we have pi 1 of x, x0. Then we have f0 star, the induced map, which goes to pi 1 of a, of f goes from what to what? To y. Pi 1 of y, what do I have to write here? F0 of x0, okay? I has to preserve base points. F0 of x0. Y0, but I don't give it. On the other hand, we have F1 star. So this goes also to pi 1 of y. And what do I have right? F1 of x0, okay? F1 of x0. It has to preserve base points. And maybe they are different, this and this. So they cannot be equal then even, because these are different groups. They maybe are isomorphic, but they are, it's not the same group, okay? They are isomorphic, but they are different. What is the isomorphism? So we say F0, then we go with alpha hat, and then we go to this group, okay? Because alpha is a path from alpha is a path from F0 x0 to F1 x0. So this is so this is an isomorphism also that we know, okay? So this is an isomorphism. So this is equivalent this to the fact that this diagram is commutative. That's exactly the same, okay? This is short and this is with all spaces, groups. It's commutative. It's a commutative diagram. In algebra, maybe you saw maybe. It's a commutative. You have all kinds of commutative diagrams. That's very important in algebra. That means following this way and following this way is the same, okay? And then you have large diagrams sometimes in algebra. What? Thank you. Because applying h, we go to y, yes. Okay, so this is the proposition, a little bit technical proposition. I indicate the proof now. So we have to prove, I'm looking at this diagram. We take an element here, okay? Let W be an element in the fundamental group of pi 1 x, x 0. We have to prove that. We have to show that, to prove that. going this way is the same. So that means that we have to prove that first alpha minus 1 First, let me start here, but it should turn. So this is W and then F0. What is this? This is F0 star of W. That's the definition of the star, okay? You take an element and you just compose with a map, okay? This is the definition of the induced map. That's exactly only the difference. On the other hand, we have W F1. So this is nothing else than F1 star of W by definition of F1 star, okay? And so we have to prove first this one, so we are here, then this one is equal to this one, okay? What is this isomorphism? Now you have to recall what is this. So I take alpha minus 1 star, this one, and then I go back with alpha. So alpha minus 1 comes from here to here, then we have this element, and then we go back, and then we are here. So this is equal. That we have to prove. That's the definition of alpha hat, this conjugation, okay? That's the definition of alpha hat, which we did some time ago. So we have to prove that. It's associative, so I don't care about, okay, from left to right, but whatever. So we have to prove that alpha minus 1, which is equivalent to the fact that alpha minus 1 times F0 W times alpha. So this represents this, okay? It's homotopic, the same class. It's homotopic H to F1 W. That is the same, okay? This equation and this equation is equal. So we have to prove, we have to find this homotopy, okay? And this I do schematically, as I used to do by a picture. That's the diagram, that's the proposition. So I want to define the homotopy, okay, H. So here we have to define, what is H? H should be a homotopy between what? Between alpha minus 1, so we have here alpha minus 1, so now we have a parameterization, okay, problem. So we take 1/4, 1/4, 1/2. But we see that reparameterizing doesn't change the homotopy class. Okay, parameterize as I want in some sense, okay? So I take 1/3, 1/3. I mean, if you make parentheses in this way, then it's 1/4, 1/4, 1/2, okay? But if you make it parentheses in this way, then this is 1/2, 1/4, 1/4. It's different parameterization, okay? I take here 1/3, 1/3, 1/3. Doesn't matter. So here we have alpha minus 1. Here we should have what? F0 times W, and here we have alpha. That's on the left-hand side, okay? On the other side, we have F1W. That's it, okay? So here we want to define our homotopy. So what is this? Is the time? This is the time interval, of course, and this is x, okay? And so homotopy goes to y. So what do we do? Well, we make our picture. We try this one. So we want to define it here at the time t, okay? We have here. We want this. Here we want this. Now we have to think, what do we want to do at time t, right? But it's we have ft also, right? We have at time zero this mapping. We have f time one this mapping. What's the homotopy? Ft. So it's clear that we should take ft times w here, okay? At here's zero. This is zero. This is one. So here if f zero w, ft w, f one w, okay, between zero and one. And then we have to say what this piece here. And this piece here. Well, I can make a picture also. We have zero and one. So we have at time one, we have W F1. At time zero, we have W F0. We have alpha. In which direction does it go? From identity, so it goes in this direction, I suppose. No. Yes. Okay. And so we have at the time t, what do we do? We go t, okay, on this path. Then at time t, we have here in this WFT, of course. Okay. So we go here. We follow this, and then we go back, okay? So this should be alpha restriction to 0t. We don't go all alpha. We just go to alpha t, then we go around here, and then we go back, okay? So this should be, we go back. So we go back. So this is alpha. Well, this is alpha minus 1, okay? Sorry. So this is alpha minus 1 restricted to, this is alpha minus 1, okay? So alpha, this is alpha minus 1 restricted to t1 or 1 minus t1, which one? Alpha minus 1 is this one. So this is 1 minus t. One. So we want alpha minus 1 here, okay? Sorry. That's just in terms of alpha minus 1 is. And this one is an and then we go here, and then we go back. So this is alpha restricted to what? T0. Something like this. Something is wrong here. So homotopy go. So I'm mixing up something. I'm sorry. Let me try again. Something is wrong here. So I want the homotopy. Let me try again. We go from this path here is alpha minus 1. What is alpha? Alpha is this path, right? From this f0 fx0. This is one f1 of x0. And so this is alpha. So here I go alpha minus 1. Then around this one, and then back with alpha, okay? And then it should be this one, homotopic to this one. Yeah. That's at time zero, I take alpha minus 1. Then this one, and then I go back with alpha here, okay? At time 1, we just have this one, okay, at time 1. And this is, so we have to prove that this path, alpha minus 1, round, back, is homotopic to this path. Right? So what we do again, at time t, we go with alpha minus 1 yeah, alpha minus 1 and 0 we are here, okay? Then I'm getting confused with the directions, okay? We have, at time zero, we have this, and going back, okay? At time one, we have this, and we have to find the homotopy. So at this very small time, what do I do? Epsilon. At time zero, I go all the way, okay? At time very small, I go up to this point, okay? And then I follow this, and then I go back. So maybe it's more clear. So this is a very small time. So alpha, what is this? That's the question here. What is this? Alpha minus 1 restricted to what? Alpha minus 1 restricted to 0, 1 minus t. Okay. And this one? So we go to this point, then we go around here, okay? And now we go back. And this is alpha, we go back with alpha. But alpha from where? From t to 1. From t to 1. Well, okay? That's, it's clear what the homotopy is, okay? It's not so clear because alpha one minus 1, alpha goes in one direction, is the other direction. So one has to concentrate on this. But now it seems to be okay, hopefully. Of course, we have to reparameterize everything, okay? We have to reparameterize. So we have to, all these three, we have to reparameterize. Okay, because this is not the unit interval any longer. This is unit interval, this is not, and this is one third only, okay. So we have to reparameterize everything in a good way. But that's no problem. The formulas are in the book, but they are not interesting. I mean, you cannot never remember. I can even, here you have to concentrate, okay. But this is form is the definition, and this is the picture to this definition, okay? So you compare this and this. Well, now theorem. If F from x to y is a homotopy equivalent. Then, so let me fix base points. With, you choose base points, f of x0 is y0, then if you have a homotopy equivalence, then f star, the induced map from pi 1 x, x0 to pi 1 y, y0 is an isomorphism. Okay, so homotopy equivalence, choosing base points in this way, which one is mapped to the other base point, then the induced map is an isomorphism. It's like for homeomorphism, right? For homeomorphism, it's the same, no? But for homeomorphism, it's easy, because these are just the functorial properties, okay? A homeomorphism induces an isomorphism of fundamental groups. These are just the two functorial properties, okay? This is very easy. Here we have to work a little bit because we have this base point problem. The base point is moving around, and so we have to take care of the base points, okay? Good, so so proof. So what means homotopy equivalence? Well, we know the definition now. We have f goes from x to y. We have g goes from y to x, such that first f, then g, is homotopic to the identity of x, and first g and then f is homotopic to the identity of y. So I make a picture now, a diagram, pi 1 x, x 0. So here we have to prove that f star is an isomorphism. This goes to pi 1 of y, y0. That should be an isomorphism. Of course, we have g star, okay? Some g star. This goes back, pi 1 x. Unfortunately, it's not x0, okay? But I have to write, so this is G star. What do I have to write? I have to write G of Y0. I have to preserve base points, okay? I don't know which point this is. G of Y0. Okay. However, this is, of course, G F star. That's the functorial property, is f star, g star. No, this is first f star, then g star. So this mapping is homotopic to the identity, okay? So the identity induces the identity. No, identity x. Star is identity of... These are the functorial properties, okay? Identity of pi 1 x, x0. Functorial properties. So this implies that these two maps are homotopic, okay? So we apply the proposition, which we proved. So this implies that f star and then g star is not equal to the identity of pi 1 of x. It cannot be equal Because we have different fundamental groups, right, here. It's a different base point, so they cannot be the identity, okay? But the thing there says that we here have some kind of alpha hat, okay? Where alpha is the path from the homology. This is a proposition. The identity, so this is just alpha hat. Because the identity we don't see, okay? So we have here, this is equal to alpha hat. And this is an isomorphism. Alpha is the path defined by this homotopy, okay? As in the proposition. And now, so what does it say? What does this imply? This is an isomorphism. So what do you say immediately for F star and G star? If this is an isomorphism, the composition is an isomorphism. First this, then this is an isomorphism. The identity doesn't occur. So what does it say about F star and G star? Sorry? F star is? No. A mapping. F star, if you have F star and then G star is an isomorphism, what property has F star? What? No, almost.
Injective.
Yes, injective. The first one is injective, the second one is surjective. Right, okay? If you have this, then this is an isomorphism, then this has to be injective and this has to be surjective, okay? This implies injective and this is surjective. That's half, right? Because now we want also surjective here. So we may go here. And now I take, again, F star. But this is not the same F star, because it's from F, but we have another base point here, okay? So it's not the same, it's not equal. Anyway, we go to pi 1 of... So what do we have to write? F, pi 1 of y, and what is the base point now? The base point is F of g of y0, okay? F of g, I have to preserve base points. F of g of y0. Well, many, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, yes. Okay? I have to preserve base points. This is not exactly the same map as this, right? Because this is with different base points, okay? However, by symmetry, okay, we again have the same stuff. So we have something here, which is some beta star, and this is an isomorphism. That's why the second one. It's the same, okay? First F, then G, now G, then F, okay? Taking care of a little bit of base points. And what does that now imply? That this is again an isomorphism. So this says then that G star is injective. And F star, F prime star is surjective. So what we proved is not that F star is an isomorphism, but that G star is an isomorphism, right? So this implies that G star is an isomorphism. But now you call GF and FG, okay? So by symmetry, it's symmetric completely, okay? And this implies by symmetry. I should have given other names, okay? Also F star is an isomorphism. So what you do, invert the rows of F and G, okay? Okay, that's it. So corollary. Now the fundamental root may depends on the base point, okay? If it's not path connected, it depends on the base point, okay? But first corollary, sorry, if X is contractible, then pi 1 of x, x0 is a trivial group. Proof. What means contractible? That means that the identity map is homotopic to a constant map. That's the definition of what? Of contractible, okay? That's the definition of contractible. The identity map is. Well, I don't want the definition, I'm not distracted. So this means that this is equivalent to fact. I didn't want to write this even. That's a definition, okay? This means that X is homotopic to a one-point space, okay? X zero. That I proved. Exercise, okay? Which I did. X is homotopic to a one-point space. And that means that what does it mean? The fundamental group of this is trivial, right? So the fundamental group of this is trivial. Okay. So if you have this mapping here, that induces this is a homotopy equivalent. So if f, there's only one map from x to x zero anyway, so it's a homotopy equivalence. And this implies F star is an isomorphism. However, the fundamental group of this is trivial, okay? Trivial fundamental group. Pi 1 of x0. x0 is trivial. Well, maybe I made it. This is trivial fundamental group, so then this is trivial fundamental group. Now you say, but maybe. Well, it's okay. So there's an exercise here, another exercise, small exercise. We didn't give so many exercises for this part, but exercise. X contractible implies X is path connected. That's a nice exercise. Well, not nice. Not difficult. So the idea of this proof, of this exercise, if it's contractible, it's path connected, okay? So what means path connected? Path connected, you have to give any two points, okay? And you have to find a path. Now, the identity map, it's contractible. It's homotopic to a constant map. Okay? X0. I don't know if I can choose this point in an arbitrary way. Okay? There's some X0, so that is homotopic. So X0 is here. But here we have a homotopy. Okay? And now I find a path from here to here and from here to here. From here to here and from here to here, okay? So I can define a path from, well, I don't know, in this direction and also in this direction, okay? And then I take here the inverse path and go from here to here and then here. So then we go here in the other direction, okay? What is this? What are these paths? Let me call these points x1, x2. So what is the path which goes from x0 to x1? This I call alpha. So alpha of t would be page of x0 t. Let me try. So at time 1, this is x0, okay? At time 0, sorry. At time 0, this is from the identity, so it's the same point, x0, and no, x0, x1. Okay? So at time 0, this is the identity, so it's x1, okay? X1. At time 1, this is the constant map x0, so it's x0. So it's a path in what direction? Sorry. It goes from here to here, okay? And then we do the same beta of t. It's h of x2t. And now it goes symmetric way, okay? It goes from x2 to x0, okay? And then, of course, first alpha minus 1. Alpha minus 1 times, it's not a composition, times, no, alpha times beta minus 1. Alpha times beta minus 1 is a path from x1 to x2. Is a path from x1 to x2, which are arbitrary points. X0, it's not so clear, okay? Well, now maybe it's clear that you can take any x0, but in the proof we have to distinguish x0 from these two points. X0 is given to us here, okay? And we cannot, or we have to prove that we can take any point, okay? But so this is contractible path. That's an exercise in the book also, which I wanted to give but forgot last time, okay? In the first chapter here, you have a long exercise on contractible spaces, okay? Can look at this. One of these is contractible is path connected. Okay. Other corollary. If x and y are path connected, and homotopic, and homotopy equivalent. Then the fundamental groups are isomorphic. Pi 1 of x, x0 is isomorphic to pi 1 of y, y0. Now it doesn't depend on the point, okay, because they are path connected. So for all x0, y0, we can choose whatever we want. For all x0 and x, y0 and y. Path-connected homotopy equivalent spaces have isomorphic fundamental groups, okay? That's homeomorphism, same, okay? Same feature as for homeomorphism. So a contractible space is a trivial fundamental group, right? And now there's a problem. If you have trivial fundamental group, is the space contractible maybe? What do you think? Is a problem? S2 is simply connected. That we prove, no? Van Kampen's theorem and so on, no? The fundamental group is trivial, okay? And it's path connected also. Then there's a question, is it contractible maybe, S2? Is S2 contractible? What do you think? I mean, intuitively. S1 is not contractible, no? Because the fundamental group is not trivial, it's that, okay? A contractible space has trivial fundamental group. S1 has non-trivial fundamental group, so it's not contractible. RP2 has non-trivial fundamental group, so it's not contractible. RPn has non-trivial fundamental group, it's non-contractible. S2, Sn, as trivial fundamental loop. So what? What do you think? I mean, contractible means that the identity map, you see the two-sphere, you can homotop to a point, okay? Is that possible with S2? Doesn't look that way, right? It's difficult. You have to by in a continuous way, right? If you take one other point, okay, then you can contract, okay? But if you have all points, then intuitively, you have it's not in a continuous way, okay? At a certain point, there will be some, how do you say? Okay, you have to cut somewhere, okay, the situation. So the answer is no. However, how to prove that? And that's not so clear, no? Because the fundamental group doesn't help here, okay? And now this is the starting point of other things in algebraic topology, okay? So if fundamental group doesn't help, you try other things, okay? And the easiest or the next one is maybe homology, okay? So then you have used homology or you have used the higher groups, okay? It's difficult to prove this directly, okay? It's difficult to prove that directly. I don't know. I never thought about that. One can use homology. The difference is that fundamental group has this one. And homology Hn, this is for all n, okay? Or pi n, there's pi n, okay? Which is maybe more difficult, but we have to generalize also for higher dimension something, okay? Or pi n. These are the higher homotopy groups, okay? Pi 1 is a fundamental group, it's the first one of these. And this is the starting point then and then this comes out, it's not contractible, okay? Because some of these groups are not trivial, okay? Hn of S2 are not trivial. But for contractible spaces, everything is trivial, okay? Contractible spaces are like a point, and everything which you can define is trivial for a point. Almost always. Okay? These for the two sphere are not trivial. H2, you need two now, okay? So, but that's not our theme. Okay, so when should I finish, by the way? I started at 11, 12:30? That's 12:30, no? Yes. So these are homotopy equivalences. This is starting of algebraic topology, okay? There's fundamental group homotopy, of course, basic, but this is then you want other functors, okay? Also, you recall that the Brouwer fixed point theory, we proved only in dimension 2. If we want to prove it in higher dimensions, we should use something which is defined for something bigger than 1, okay? This one. Our model is easier, this also, but this is a homotopy groups, these are the homology groups, okay? So there is a need to generalize to higher dimensions. There are direct proofs of the Brouwer fixed point theory, but this is very nice, but you don't have to use this. But okay, so the last thing which I wanted to do is to give you an example of a space with non-commutative. All groups are very easy, you know. Z2, Z times Z, or easy abelian groups, okay? So now I give you an example just to finish. That's not typical for fundamental groups. Fundamental groups are difficult, okay? This is misleading a little bit, okay? These are easy groups, if you saw, but in general it's very difficult, okay? Because they're non-abelian. That's the point, okay? Non-abelian groups are difficult. So example. I close with an example of a space which has non-abelian fundamental group. And you take the easiest possible, so you take this and this. Well, I drew it, but I will need more space upstairs, sorry. So what is this? These are two circles which have one point in common, okay? This is two circles with one point in common. This is called figure 8. That's 8, right? That's 8. Figure 8. Which you use for infinity. What is this? This is a picture in R2, of course, okay? So this is subspace of R2. Two circles. And this is our base point, x0. So the fundamental group of this, it's not here. These are not disks. These are circles, okay? So this is one circle. The fundamental group of it is z, okay? What you count is rotation numbers of this part. Of this part, the same. You count fundamental group z, no? Now you take a path, this path, and then this path, and then this, and then the other one, okay? And you see no way how they might commute up to homotopy. You cannot transfer something which goes one time around here to something which goes around here. That seems to be impossible, right? So they shouldn't commute. So I call this A, and I call this B. These are also paths, okay? This goes one time around here, this goes one time around here, okay? And I want to prove that A times B is not homotopic to B times A. Okay? That's what I said. So that means A times B is different from B times A. And that means it's non-commutative here, okay? The fundamental group is not commutative of this figure 8. But how to prove that, okay? So I prove it in a very nice way because we use coverings. And I define a covering of this, okay? I hope I don't have a picture here, but no. So I do the following. I have to define a map, a projection, a covering. Okay. So these are four circles. It's always in R2, okay? Subspace of R2. So I have to define this map P. Well, I have names here, A, B, so the easiest way I say what is happening. So here I go to A. If I go from here to here, I go one time around here, okay? So this and this point go both to this point, right? So this is E0, this is E1, this is E2, 3 points. So E0, E1 goes to one time around here, okay? Then here I take another time, A. So E1, E0, so going one time around here goes two times around here now, okay? That looks familiar, okay? And then what I do here, now I'm in E1, and here, go all to this point, right? So the fiber, P minus 1 of X0, are 3 points. What are they? E0, E1, E2. Okay, 3 points. So here now, I go on the other side, B. So this defines my mapping. Here I go to A, here I go to B, okay? And here I do a similar thing. Here, this I goes to B one time around. This goes to B second time around. And this goes to A. So one time around here, one time around here, okay? Like this, one time around here, one time around here. Okay? That defines my mapping P. So P is a threefold covering. Well, that's clear because for any point, any fiber has three elements, okay? This are these 3 points, okay? And for any other point, for example, and locally it's a homeomorphism, no? Because this looks like this locally, right? A neighborhood of X0 looks like this, right? A small neighborhood. And in small neighborhoods of these, of course, look exactly the same, right? So these are homeomorphisms. And if you take any other point, maybe you take this point, and I look for the preimage, okay, of this one. What is the preimage of this point? Is this
It's this and it's this.
Okay, again, three copies. Okay, so this is a threefold covering. This is a threefold covering. Each fiber has three elements. Is it clear how the mapping is defined, P? It should be clear from the picture, no? This means these points going from here to here go to these points one time around, okay, with constant velocity always. That's the mapping also, okay? So this defines the mapping. The picture defines the mapping. And now, we want to prove this now. Now A and B are also passes, okay? Now A and B are also passes. So it takes a path A times B, and I lift with initial point. Well, my base point is E0, has endpoint. What is the endpoint? Well, you tell me, what is the endpoint? First A, then B, lift. First A, so I lift A. I go one time around here, okay? I lift, so I go here, right? And then B. So I go around here, B, okay? So the endpoint is E1. I don't even use here the lifting lemma now because it's clear that they lift, okay? Here you see everything. It's very explicit, okay? You can lift passes here, this pass, no? And then I take B times A tilde, this initial point E0. This is always our initial point, okay? As endpoint, what is the endpoint? Well, first B now, okay? So I lift B from this point. Well, the only way is this. It's unique also. And then A. So I go just one time. So E2. I finish on the other side. That's endpoint E2. That's trivial. Now, this picture, okay, defines everything. You see everything. It's very geometric. However, so these two passes, this is A times B, the liftings of A times B and B times A with the same initial point have different endpoints. This implies that A times B is not homotopic to B times A. If they would be homotopic, then they must have the same endpoint by the homotopy lifting lemma. If they are homotopic, their liftings have the same endpoint. They have the same initial point by definition, have also the same endpoint, which is not the case. They have different endpoints. So they cannot be homotopic by the homotopy lifting lemma, and it's corollary by the homotopy lifting lemma. And it's corollary. If you look at this, I formulated this as a corollary. Okay, so they are not homotopic. And that's exactly what I wrote here. That means A times B is not B times A. So this implies that the fundamental group is not commutative, okay? So this implies, so to finish, pi 1 of whatever this is called, no name. B, basis of the, okay, figure 8. Pi 1 of B, the base point x0, is not commutative. It's not abelian. This is not an abelian group. So you ask, what is this group? Okay, so what group is it? It's not an abelian group, no, okay? It's not Z. Well, you suspect 2 times Z, okay? There's one here and one here, no? 2 circles, okay? So you have a Z here, a Z here. But they don't commute, these 2 Zs. They don't commute, okay? These 2 copies. So it's not Z times Z, no? It's not a product. It's called the free product. That's a non-commutative version, okay? It is a free product of Z times Z, okay? So this is called Z. That's a free product. A non-commutative version of the abelian product, okay? Of the product. A non-commutative version. And this is called also the free non-abelian group of rank 2. So this is the free, well, I don't know, free non-abelian group. Well, it's of rank 2. That's what it's called, the fundamental group. Free non-abelian group of rank 2. There's also the free abelian group of rank 2. No, what is that? That's Z times Z. Okay? The free, I don't know, you did group theory. The free abelian group of rank 2. Is Z times Z. This is not times, this is a star, okay? That's a free product. This is a direct product, okay? So it's a different version. This is a non-abelian version, if you want, of this, okay? And so this is a free abelian group of rank 2, and the fundamental group of this is a free non-abelian group of rank 2, okay? It has two generators. The generators are this path, of course, no, for the right-hand side, and this path for the left-hand side. One generates this, and the other generates this, but they don't commute. This is the fundamental group of the torus. Here they commute, okay? This is also pi 1 of torus. This is a free abelian group of rank 2, okay? The figure 8 is a free non-abelian group. So this is the beginning of group theory, also infinite group theory, okay? Free groups, free non-abelian groups. These are the first groups of infinite group theory. I don't know, did you do that in algebra?
Just finite groups.
Just finite groups, no infinite groups. Yeah. So this is starting of infinite groups. Free abelian groups, free non-abelian groups, okay? These are the first examples, important examples of infinite group theory. Okay.